The South Africans have hit back tonight against allegations of food poisoning and poor sportsmanship, while the hotel where the All Blacks ate in Johannesburg has denied all responsibility and blames the players themselves.
10 of the 15 players who ran onto Ellis Park for the final had suffered acute stomachache, and according to Laurie Maines, few of the whole squad escaped. A remarkable coincidence in his eyes.
It was just an amazing sequence of events and coincidence that of our 35-man party that ate at that particular lunch venue in the hotel here, about 27 of them went down in the space of 12 hours. And you can read what you like into that, but I don't think it was coincidence.
But although Laurie Maine's life is now far removed from his time as All Black coach, he still has unfinished business, is still paying for a private investigator to find out more about that fateful World Cup lunch in South Africa.
It's just one of those personal things. Often when I get hold of something, I can't let go till I'm satisfied. And this is just one of them. We know that we were poisoned, basically. I've had it from two independent sources, rather by chance. I had the results of an investigation that were done internally in South Africa revealed to me.
At the end of a grueling and great afternoon.
It was to have been the grand end to an incredible World Cup. Instead, it was a struggle. Their coach has discovered that a kitchen hand admitted she was paid to put a substance in the tea and coffee served in the dining room. Those players arriving late for lunch weren't affected, their brews were fresh.
But management at the team hotel reacted angrily to the innuendo tonight. The All Blacks had their own separate catering staff and eating area, and the staff ate from the same menu as the players as part of the hotel security policy, and none of them fell ill.
We take extraordinary precautions, and that's why we always liaise closely with management. And to hear that, and then there's some sort of almost malicious attempt to, almost like innuendos, to blame us at conspiring to ensure the loss of the team, well, that's just really totally unacceptable. And I can tell you, we're reserving our rights to take any further action at this stage.
Do you think there's an element of sour grapes here causing some sort of delayed illness?
Well, I don't think we'd like to comment whether it's sour grapes. I'm not so sure they've had so many complaints if they'd won the game, if that's the answer to the question.
Leaving another bad taste with the All Blacks was South African rugby president Louis Leite, who said in his after-match speech that the Springboks would have won in 1987 and 91 if they'd been allowed to take part. The All Blacks were appalled and left early, as did the French and English. On Homes Tonight, Leite denied he'd been offensive.
No, of course not. I wish you were there, because then you could have smiled with me. I had tongue in the cheek when I said these things. How would I be insulting to our greatest rugby friends in the world?
He wasn't being funny, he was deadly serious in our view, and obviously in the view of Peter Falk, and obviously in the view of the English rugby team and the French rugby team and the referees. So I don't think it was just our view. You know, it was disappointing.